in like that?
Sorry, I forgot. God, how long are you going to keep this up for, Emma? It's ridiculous.
I just need a bit of privacy, that's all.
Is it something I've done? Something I've said?
No, I've told you, but just leave me alone.
Look, I'm not a monster, you know. I've just come to get my razor. I thought you were supposed to be staying in bed today.
Jude? Morning.
Morning. What?
Looked like you had a fight with a paint pot.
Oh, very funny. Just spent the whole weekend decorating. Not only does it turn out to be a disgusting colour, but I went and spilt the turp so the flat stinks and I can't get this stupid stuff off.
Oh, well, I've got just the thing for you.
Oh, yeah.
Morning.
Hi. Jude?
There you go. Let's just talk you out.
What exactly am I supposed to do with that?
Put it on your hands with a little bit of water and rub.
Ew, it's disgusting.
Oh, don't be such a wuss. It's fantastic.
So this is what you cyclists get up to on a rainy Sunday, is it? God, you're worse than train spotters.
Look, it's not going to come off like that. Oh, come here.
Yeah, I think I've got the gist of it there. You better go and put some clothes on. Get ready for surgery.
Yeah, right. It's 5:02 already. I'll see you later then.
Okay. Oh, get a grip, girl. You and doctors do not mix.
When are you going to start dressing properly for work?
What? What, you don't think my cycling gear's appropriate? Look, I can't be doing the jacket and tie bit. It makes me feel like I'm still back at school.
Nurses wear a uniform, why shouldn't we?
Are you serious?
You need to think about the signals you're giving out, Ben. I mean, you might think it's all very casual and reassuring, but open neck shirt and slacks tell an employer you're not really 100% serious about the job.
Mark, this isn't the army.
No, but it's just as hierarchical. If you want responsibility, you've got to look like you can take it. You don't want to be a locum all your life, do you?
No.
Then think about it.
No Jude yet?
No.
How many house calls are there this morning?
Oh, there's about average. Why?
Jude might be a bit late, that's all. But we'll manage.
Well, one doctor down already. She better not be too late.
Oh, why haven't you left for work?
I'm worried about you, Emma.
If I can manage a team of 15 renegade executives, I think I can look after myself.
I know that. You're a wonderful, amazing woman. That's why I married you.
That and the salary.
And the salary. But there's a point at which strength can become a weakness.
Spare me the philosophy lesson.
We can't keep pretending this isn't happening, Em. It's difficult for me.
Here we go, back to sex again. Not servicing you frequently enough, am I?
Oh, please, Em, you haven't let me know you for months.
Well, you wouldn't want to even if I did, would you?
You know that's not true.
Isn't it? Anyway, I don't want to talk about it anymore.
Look, please, I think it might be to do with your mum.
Oh, now we're into amateur psychology as well, are we?
OK, if you won't talk to me about it, maybe you'll talk to the doctor when he comes.
Look, I've put on a bit of weight and I'm a bit depressed. It's not the end of the world, all right?
All right, OK. I'll see you later.
Hello. Are you here to see the patient?
That's right, Dr. Mark Elliott.
John Shepherd, the husband. Pleased to meet you. Well, good luck. She's extremely adept at deflecting unwanted attention.
Oh, thanks for the warning. Do you know what's wrong with her?
What, officially or unofficially?
Either.
Well, officially, it's this bad chest infection. Unofficially, it's a disaster. She cries a lot, although she thinks I don't know it. Locks herself in the bathroom for hours. Won't look in a mirror. And, well, she won't let me touch her.
Have you talked about it at all?
Well, sure, I've tried. She just gets defensive. It started about 4 months ago when her mother died. I don't know, maybe you could just find a way of getting her to talk about it without making it seem as if I've said nothing.
Discretion is my middle name.
Thank you. I'll, she'll let you in.
Thank you.
Surgery? Yeah, can you hold, please? Thanks. Jude still isn't answering her mobile, and there aren't any sneaky messages on the out-of-hours answer machine like there was last time she threw a sickie.
OK, leave Jude's patient files there. Ben and I will work through them as and when. Call Mark and tell him to get through his house calls as soon as he can, and if Jude does call, put her straight through to me. Right, Mrs. Willis.
She's in for it this time. Yes, can you hold for another minute, please?
Well, the infection seems to have taken a pretty good hold. How much rest have you been getting?
Some. It's been a bit hectic at work.
Well, it's likely to get a bit more hectic if you take 3 weeks off instead of one.
You sound just like John.
I'm flattered. Everything else all right? No mood swings or anything?
Fine. Just irritated I can't get back to work.
That's nice. Those your parents or his?
His. Alarmingly sentimental about them.
What about your parents?
My dad was all right. He was a sweetie, but Mum could be a bit of a harridan.
I take it they're both dead, then?
Dad died years ago. Mum, just the other month.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Why? We all die at some stage.
You must miss her sometimes, though.
No. No, I don't. She was so critical. Nothing was ever good enough. When I think about her, all I feel is betrayed, neglected, and unloved. So no, I don't.
Yes, well, things were different for women in those days, weren't they? I mean, you don't know what she might have been through. She may not have expressed it, but I'm sure she loved you very much.
I've heard all the old clichés before, Doctor. She never wanted me in the first place. She told me so to my face. I was quite grown up at the time, old enough to know that she meant it.
Have you considered bereavement counselling?
What is it to grieve? Oh, I'm sorry, I've not been very nice, am I? In fact, I'm sounding just like her. Help.
Well, I won't say anything for fear of using a cliché. Anyway, I'd better be off. If I could just wash my hands.
Just through there.
Thank you.
It's like cruise station in here today.
Yeah, thanks a bunch, Jude. She's probably off buying knickers for bridesmaids or something equally as vital.
Has Jude turned up?
Does it look like it?
You don't have any idea where she might have gone, do you?
No.
I thought she might have said something. She didn't seem worried or angry about anything.
Are you kidding? Miss Midland's Bride of the Year. Have you two had a row or something?
Yeah. Well, no, I don't know what I've done. She's just gone.
What, you mean she's done a runner?
Oh, she'll be all right, Pete.
She hasn't had any visitors, has she? Any old friends turning up? Ex-husbands?
No, not that I know of.
Mr. Davison.
Thanks.
OK.
It's a hefty dose of antibiotics, I'm afraid.
Thanks.
That's a nasty-looking bruise. How did you get that?
Oh, I keep bumping into the bathroom door. I'm always doing it.
I've been thinking of getting a shaver like this for myself. Are they any good?
John seems to think so. He's had one for years.
Anyway, I'd better be off. Don't bother seeing me to the door. You need to rest.
And what about Pete, eh? I told you I could smell it coming.
Oh, it's probably nothing.
Are you joking? Jude had that rabbit in the headlights look about her all last week. And what was Pete going on about ex-husbands?
Oh, you're so cruel.
No, just a simple observation of fact.
Bet you the wedding's off. Speaking of which, you owe me 20 quid.
I do not.
Oh, yes, you do.
I'm sorry to interrupt the unseasonal panto, but am I going to get to see a doctor this week?
Oh, I'm terribly sorry, Mrs. Miller, but they're doing the best they can.
Apart from turning up, of course. It's a good job I'm not at death's door, isn't it?
That's a matter of opinion.
You all right?
Yeah, fine.
This place is turning into Faulty Towers.
Oh, and I bet you Jude sat at home with her feet up, watching a video of the runaway bride.
That is not funny.
Oh, I wish I'd never got up this morning. And where have you been? It's been bedlam here.
Yes, I did my best. Katrina, do we really need this idiot's going to the surgery?
Well, what's wrong with it?
Well, it's somewhat clumsy, isn't it? Especially with half the staff missing.
It's good modern management strategy, actually. I do have a degree in it.
Yes, of course. Well, do you think you could redo it a bit more professionally? You know, just tidy it up a bit. Right, who's left? Mrs. Peters. This way, please. Well, I thought she might be self-hurting. She's got depression, bereavement, bruising, physical self-loathing and obsessive secretive behaviour.
She always struck me as level-headed.
Well, her husband have noticed something.
Not necessarily. Not if she's doing it behind closed doors and cutting herself in places you wouldn't normally see. Her thighs, torso. I've come across it before in traumatised women in Bosnia. It's not pretty.
And she's angry with her mother.
Yeah, there's a volcano waiting to erupt. You know, I'd quite like to have another word with the husband. See if he can tell me anything else.
Well, be careful. He might go in with a sledgehammer and tip her over the edge.
That's true. Maybe I should go back there myself, see what I can find out.
Sounds like he's planning a military campaign.
Well, you can take the man out of the army.
What are you doing?
Well, I thought we could start a kitty for tea and biscuits. There's no point it coming out of surgery funds, is there?
No way, Jose. I'd rather the surgery subsidise Katrina's chocolate habit than me.
All right. No problem. But I have been thinking about the Well Man and the Young Person's Clinic.
You're full of ideas today, aren't you, Action Man?
What about them?
Well, at the moment they're on a drop-in basis, which is ridiculous because we can be waiting here for 2 hours and no one can turn up.
There's a very good reason they're on a drop-in basis. Professional men prefer not to make appointments in advance.
And teenagers are incapable of it. Otherwise you'd just be sitting there waiting for them if they did.
That's a rather cynical view of your fellow man.
Rather accurate, more like.
Well, couldn't we just try it on an appointments basis just for a week?
You don't take no for an answer, do you?
No.
All right, we'll try it for 1 week.
Oh, what it's...
Creep up on people like that. It's really freaky.
Worried about the finances, are you?
No, I'm just trying to make a few savings, that's all.
Well, you could start with this accountant's bill. That's a bit steep.
We don't want to be late for afternoon surgery, do we?
Have you heard anything from Jude?
What is wrong with everyone today?
Oh, sorry.
Oh, never mind.
Has she been in at all?
No, she hasn't.
She hasn't left any messages or anything?
No. But you don't know what this is all about, do you?
No.
It's just that with Mac being on holiday, well, you think she'd have found a better time to have gone walkabout. Oh, don't look so worried. She probably just wants a bit of time to herself. It's not as if she's going to go and jump off a cliff or anything, is it?
Well, if she does come in or get in touch, will you ask her to phone Beth? Urgently.
Join the queue.
Hello again. I was on my way back to the surgery. I thought I'd pop in and see how you were getting on. I've got a feeling you might be better off on a different course of antibiotics.
Well, I haven't had a chance to get the first lot yet.
Good. Could I come in just have another quick look at you? It won't take long.
I'm surprised you came back, actually. I thought I'd frightened you off.
That's all right. Bereavement brings out all sorts of things in all of us.
Sorry, Sherlock. I'm afraid I'm like that anyway.
I don't think you are. Not really. At the risk of using another cliché, I think it might be worth considering you could be a bit depressed.
Oh, please, you'll be prescribing me Valium next.
No, but it might be worth considering antidepressants.
Sorry, I'm neither weak nor mad.
Fine. Let's deal with the matter in hand then, shall we? If you could just sit over here, I'll have another quick look at you. Right. All right. Sorry. I can't really hear. Would you mind lifting up your nightie? Just for a second, and then I'll be out of here. Leave you in peace. Emma, please. There's no point in pretending. Just let me see them. I can help you.
What is it to laugh at?
I'm sorry. I thought you were cutting yourself. I thought they were scars. They're not. They look more like stretch marks.
I don't understand. Stretch marks.
Do you have any children?
No. How come I've got stretch marks if I've never even been pregnant?
It's hard to say without doing any tests, but I think you might have Cushing's syndrome.
What on earth's that?
Well, it's caused by an excess of corticosteroid in the body, which causes these kind of stretch marks. Weight gain, bruising, excessive hair growth. I presume that's what the razors are about.
Didn't know what was happening. My body suddenly started changing. I've been obsessed with shaving it off. I felt so disgusting I hadn't let John near me.
Why didn't you come down to the surgery?
I was mild at first. I thought it would just go away. I thought it was an early menopause or something. Then Mum died and I couldn't face thinking about things. I just wanted it all to go away. to be me again.
You will. Don't worry. Are you on any other medication, any steroid drugs?
No.
Then it's a possibility that this is being caused by a tumour either on your pituitary or adrenal gland. It's not cancer. But if that is what's causing the problem, then what it requires is a simple operation to remove the lump. It will take time, but you will get back to normal.
As far as that's possible for me.
Do you want me to ring John, see if he can get back home from work?
It's memory dial one. Such an idiot.
Oh, nonsense. You've had a lot on your plate. Just remember, though, when you do recover from this chest infection, you really should still take it easy until we get to the cause of the problem.
From now on, I'm going to face up to things. And who knows? We take a look at this mother stuff.
Good.
Maybe I haven't been able to let go of the anger, because if I do, I'll have to see that I still love her underneath. I'll have to accept that Mum, whatever her faults, did her best. Who says she had to love me as well?
I'll see you at the surgery in a few days then.
Thanks. Bye.
Bye.
What made you think of the mirror?
I thought it was unlikely Emma was cutting herself. Seemed like the logical thing to do. Stick her in front of her dressing table mirror and distract her long enough to have a look at her torso.
If you're that devious on house calls, what were you like on the battlefield?
Oh, straight for the heart every time. Good evening. Surgery? No, we didn't make any inquiry. Ah, Dr. Elliot. Yes. Well, I'm sorry you've wasted your time, but we're very happy with the accountant we've got. Thank you. Bye.
What was that?
Why don't you ask Dr. Elliot here?
I happened to see the accountancy bill for last year, and I thought we could probably do better, so I made some inquiries.
Why was he looking at the accountancy bills?
I was doing some paperwork at the desk, and he was spying over my shoulder. Oh, he's been at it all day. On at me and Ben about wearing a uniform, changing the young person's clinic, the staff photo thing, the tea kitty.
And the notices. What's this all about, Mark?
Well, it's just a few ideas I've had in the past few weeks. Mac asked me to keep an eye on things while he was away, and I thought I'd put some of them into practice before he came back. It was well meant.
I appreciate your efforts, but may I remind you, you've only been here 6 weeks. If you've got any changes to suggest in Mac's absence, they should go through me as the senior partner.
Sorry, I did go at it like a bull in a china shop, as usual.
I'm sorry, Mark. This isn't an army barracks and we're not your squaddies. We're all part of a team and as such deserve equal respect and understanding. And that goes for everyone. We've all had a long, hard day and whatever Jude's reasons for not being here, I'm sure they're valid. Not one of us is in a position to judge. Listen to me, I'm sounding like a sergeant major now.
I'm sorry. It was well meant.
Yes, I know.
Actually, I think you'd make rather a good Sergeant Major.
Someone else. Don't tell anyone anything. Just come home, Jude. We're safe.
There you go.
Thanks.
I like this new passive view. You should try it more often. Oh. Hey, come on. It's going to be all right. You'll be just as beautiful as you were before.
No, I won't. You'll never want me again. I feel a freak. Look at me.
I am, Emma. And even if you had eight heads and were striped like a zebra, I'd still love you. I draw the line at mucking out, though.
Jude, please, please ring me back. I'm not lying, just get to a newspaper. Please don't do anything stupid. It's not us. We're going to be all right, Jude. Just come home. Please. Everything's going to be all right.